Hey everyone, in this tutorial we're going to talk about how to correctly adjust for body offsets, as well as how to display the correct hand gestures when converting 3D motions for use in Cartoon Animator 4. Right now we have a 2D character prepared that is already linked to the 3D motion converter with this walking motion. You'll see that the 3D dummy is moving forward in a 3D viewport towards the camera, but the 2D character doesn't get any closer. What you can do in this scenario is to head over to the Body tab and select the Enable Z-axis option. You'll see the character will now make progress towards the camera. If you want to increase the amount of distance the character moves towards the camera, then you can use the slider below. If you have a character walking towards the camera at a front-facing profile, you can use the same strength slider to increase the distance traveled towards the camera. If we go into 3D view and play back after we've recorded the motion to the timeline, you'll see that the character will actually move forward in the 3D space as well. Here we have an example of a back-facing character with a walking forward motion. You'll see he'll walk backwards and it will seem pretty strange. Let's change our camera projection angle to 180 degrees so he walks the correct way. However, you'll see that the body is still twisted, so what we need to do is go into the Body tab and find the Back Character checkbox. Once we select that, Cartoon Animator automatically knows that the character is back-facing and will adjust the motion accordingly. Let's look at the Motion Offset tool next, which allows you to modify various aspects of each 3D motion. The motion you see right here is a walking motion, however, we're going to change it to a climbing motion. In the Body tab, there are a few sliders in the Motion Offset section that you can use to adjust the look of the walk to make it seem like he's walking up a hill that you can see as a silhouette in the background. Once you're done adjusting the neck, torso, and hip values, you can go ahead and apply the new walking root motion to the timeline. At the end of the motion clip, move your character to a position further up the hill where you want the walk to terminate and play back. You'll see the walking animation is more like climbing now than walking. Lastly, let's focus on getting the correct hand position when converting a 3D to a 2D animation. If we go to the Hand tab with this character selected, you'll see that the tab will be disabled, since our character doesn't have bone hands applied. To apply bone hands to the character, first go into the Character Composer, and then into the Body tab, the Hands folder, and under G3, you will find a Bone Hand folder. From there, let's just apply these bone hands that are made specifically for our character Martha, and go back into Stage Mode. In your Motion folder under 3D Motions, you'll find a hand animation that you can click and drag to apply to the 3D dummy in the Import 3D Motion panel. Once we do that, we can go to the Hand tab and see that we now have a couple of options enabled, which include the hand direction and whether or not the hand is facing up or down in that direction. You can click on each of the icons to see all the possible combinations. If we play back the motion the first time, you'll see that the 3D dummy character will turn its hand, but the 2D character will remain in a front-facing hand profile. To resolve this, we need to enable the Auto Hand Flip checkbox, otherwise the 2D character's hand will remain in a forward-facing profile. When we do so and play back again, you'll see that the hand will now flip properly. You can see an animated illustration here on how the hand appears on a 2D character when flipped from one direction to the next. That's about it for this tutorial, guys. Make sure to check out our other 3D motion converter tutorials and our forums at forum.reillusion.com, and I'll see you in the next video.